Hello and welcome to Sport This Morning. I'm Cecilia Amogbe.
It's great to have you join us again. I'm Tayo Salam.
Let's get started with the show. And of course, we're starting with the ITTF World Championship. You have a lot of Nigerian players in action today. The big boys
Yes.
will get set
The
today.
big boys and the girl, okay now. The big boys and the lady. That's Arnaud Quadri, Segun Torella, and Funke Oshoneke will be in action in Dusseldorf, Germany, later today.
That's where the action is. Also on the program, well, it's almost a done deal for
Almost.
Henry Onyekuru. That's a
Almost.
Nigerian star that is going to Arsenal.
That's the key there. It's
Will he be
almost a
finalized
done.
today?
Yeah, we'll find out really, but it's looking ever close now. I mean, Arsenal have apparently triggered his release clause. So it looks like he's on his way to London. Okay, let's move on with the show now. Still talking football, and after months of speculation, Arsene, over his future, obviously, Arsene Wenger will stay on as Arsenal manager after signing a new 2-year deal on Tuesday. Official confirmation is expected today. Cecilia, is either you in the Wenger in camp or the Wenger out camp?
None of it.
But it's obviously Wenger in. This was never in doubt.
It was never in doubt. But for some of the fans who want anyone, I would say, thank you. But no thanks, you have to go. I think all of
Back.
them have to wait for another two
And 2
years
years.
to see if he's going to leave. I think
Simple
he
as
might just
that.
want to go the way of Sir Alex Ferguson.
Right.
Win something. I mean, when I mean something, it's the
The Premier League,
Premier League
right?
title. And after that, you can say, okay, I need to go. And also, maybe the Champions League is possible, right?
Why not?
Okay.
Yeah, we'll talk more about Arsene Wenger later on the show, but it's only right to start with the French Open, and there was a major upset yesterday, day three of the French Open. Roma's champion Alexander Zverev was knocked out by Fernando Verdasco. That for me was the biggest upset on day three. Before we come back to Alexander Zverev, let's look at some of the other matches that went down at Roland Garros yesterday. And Andy Murray started on a very bright note, very good note, with a very good win over his Russian opponent there. And it looks to me like Andy Murray is starting to grow in confidence. I mean, just the way he played this particular match, even though he dropped a set, but he still found a way to win.
Too early to say for me. That's it. It's just too early because Andy Murray, when you feel okay, he's gotten his groove back, but then somehow he gets to struggle. But this result, a cool one, in 2-4 sets. He dropped a set, but then he was able to recover. And the way he won the final set was spectacular. It's only the second set that he dropped. But I think he just discovered that, okay, confidence level, you're better than Kuznetsov. I think maybe that's what gave it to him.
They're
and
on
he
the
just
same
had to
level.
Go ahead and he won this one through to the second round. But we'll see what's going to happen.
We'll see what's going to happen, right? Yeah, I agree with you. It's too early to say. I mean, there's still a long way to go before we get to the championship rounds at the French Open. But the good news is Ivan Lendl is back. They're back together. It's been away for a long time. And who knows, you know, that reunion might just, you know, spur Andy Murray to greater heights in the competition. Elsewhere, Stan Wawrinka, Cecilia, Stan has been flying under the radar. He's had a very underwhelming season as well, too.
The three of them, 1, 2, 3.
Right, very interesting. But we haven't really focused on him a lot.
Because you're having Djokovic and Andy Murray also misbehaving. Maybe
true,
that's the
true,
reason.
True, true, true. But he's advanced as well to the second round of the French Open with straight sets win for Stan Wawrinka. Nick Kyrgios as well too, through to the second round now with a straight sets win over Philipp Kohlschreiber. Thomas Berdych through Gael Monfils as well through to the next round of the French Open. So like I said, apart from Alexander Zverev, who was surprisingly beaten by Fernando Verdasco, day three went according to plan.
Yeah, if you check Fernando Verdasco, they call him a clay court veteran.
He is.
So he's been there for a long time. And when you have players like that who are really a veteran, then it tells you a whole lot about such a players. But then it ended 4-6, 6-3, 4-6 6-2.
The
That's
ladies.
The way that one ended. For the ladies, but Agnieszka Radwanska, she won her game against Ferro 6-1, 6-1. Just clinical about that. Simona Halep, she's right now the favorite to win because all the favorites...
She is.
She is favorite to win this one against Iana Keplova. She won the 6-2, 6-3. Also, you have Madison Keys and A. Batty, 6-3. 6-2, that one ended. Then yeah. Joanna Konta, that was the upset of the day.
She
lost
singles.
To a player that is ranked 109, who is actually making her debut, you know, in the tournament, losing by that margin. You would say, well, she is not really, as in clear cut is not really her favorite.
It's not a thing, but still, you don't want to see her, you know, crashing out in the second round. But that's how it went down on day three of the French Open. Action will continue today. Second round action. You expect to see the likes of Rafael Nadal, Novak Djokovic, and the likes in action today. So that's it for the French Open. Let's move on now and talk about golf. And the only one, okay, just one man is in.
Is
making
golf,
headlines.
What championship, right? Table tennis.
I'm always so excited to talk about Tiger Woods.
Yeah, Tiger Woods, come on. Because it's sad news, right?
Yeah, okay. Not because it's sad news, just because it's so topical at the moment and it's going through a lot. But let's talk about table tennis.
Okay, you're trying your support.
Table tennis.
Nigerian players that will be in action today. We'll talk about, this is the big day. We're having an African champion, talking about Haruna Quadri. He will be in action today. Funke Shinanke, she's into the main draw, so she will be facing Moa Hirano. I think from Japan, that's Asian champion. Remember what happened in 2015 also? She also faced a champion in the knockout phase. But then we'll see what's going to happen in that one. Shergun Terrell, of course, will be in action against Carlsen M from Sweden. And we have Arnold Quadri against Gustavo Gomez of China.
Interesting, Gustavo Gomez, China. That name doesn't sound Chinese in any shape or form.
Like South America.
Interesting. Yeah, like so good luck to the three of